Hello friends, in this video we are going to see various types of cements. Cements such as ordinary Portland cement, rapid hardening cement, pozzolana Portland cement, then we have blast furnace slag cement, white cement. Why these cements are used, where these cements are used and how they are manufactured, that we are going to see in this video. Types of cement. We have seen what is cement and how it is formed, how it is manufactured. Now we will see the types of cements. So the first type of cement is ordinary Portland cement. While taking the history of cement, I had told you that there was a cement which was introduced by Joseph Aspudin in 1824. So it is nothing but that cement, ordinary Portland cement. The next type of cement is rapid hardening cement. And as the name says, it will rapidly hard or it will gain strength early. Next is PPC, that is Portland pozzolana cement. Next is blast furnace slag cement. Then we have low heat Portland cement, then white cement. This is a special type of cement, costly. And next, oil well cement. Next, sulfate resisting cement. And last, hydrophobic cement. So we will see one by one what is this cement. So the first type of cement is ordinary Portland cement. As I told you, it was introduced by Joseph Aspudin in 1824. It is the most commonly type used cement. And this type of cement is used where there is no exposure to sulfates, means we cannot use in the ground where there are chances of soil which will have sulfate attacks or which will have sulfates in it. So we cannot use this cement in that location. And this cement has three grades. The first is 33 grade, second is 43 grade, and last 53 grade cement. The IS code which is used for this 33 grade cement is IS 269-1989. The IS code which is used for 43 grade of cement is IS 8112-1982, and the IS code which is used for 53 grade of cement is IS 12269-1987. We may have heard about various brand names of this type of cement. So the brand name that which are commonly available in the market are first L&T, or you may have heard about Birla, then JK cement and etc. So these are the various brand names which are available for OPC. And the specific gravity of this type of cement is 3.12 to 3.15. Second type of cement is rapid hardening cement. So as the name says, it will be a cement which develops its strength rapidly or early. Now, what is the reason of development of this and this property of rapid hardening to this cement is due to its fineness. Because it is very fine, its fineness is greater than 3250 cm² per gram. So because of this fineness, or you can say specific surface area, as it is greater than 3250 cm² per gram, therefore this cement hardens or it gets strength early. Now, how this cement made rapid hard? Because of increased percentage of C3S, that is tricalcium silicate. The percentage of C3S is up to 70% in this type of cement. So because of this, it gets its strength as early as possible. Next, how much its strength now? So for the same water content, the strength of rapid hardening cement in 1 day will be equal to strength development of ordinary Portland cement in 3 days. Similarly, the strength developed by RHC, that is rapid hardening cement, in 7 days is same as that of strength developed by OPC in 28 days. So this much strength is gained by the rapid hardening cement in early stages. The 1 day strength of rapid hardening cement for the same water cement ratio will be 3 days strength of OPC, that is ordinary Portland cement. Similarly, the rapid hardening strength that develops its strength in 7 days will be equal to the strength developed by OPC, that is ordinary Portland cement, in 28 days. Now, where this rapid hardening cement is used? First, it is used where formwork has to be removed earlier. It is also used in the repair works of roads, that is highways, or even on runways. Because in case of roads and highways, what happens? You cannot halt the traffic for a very long time. Therefore, the repair works of this is done by rapid hardening cement. Similarly, this cement can also be used in prefabricated works and in cold weather concreting, in cold weathers. Because in prefabricated works, what we need, we have to gain the strength as early as possible. Therefore, we can use this cement in prefabricated works also, in factories. And in cold weathers, we need the strength in the initial stages, and due to the cold regions or colder weather, there are possibilities that it will not gain strength properly. Similarly, for the repair works, there are chances of opening the traffic as early as possible. We need that traffic to be opened as early as possible. Therefore, in the repair works, we also use the rapid hardening cement. And at where it is used, at the locations where formwork has to be removed as early as possible. So these are the uses of rapid hardening cement. Now, where it should not be used? It should not be used in mass concreting works, where the amount of cement required is much more. Therefore, in mass concreting work, this cannot be used. For example, in the construction of dams. Now, where this cement should not be used? This should not be used at places of mass concreting. And what is mass concreting? When the cement is required in large quantities, that concreting is called as mass concreting. For example, in the construction of dams, the cement required is very large. Therefore, at these locations or at these constructions, this cement should be avoided. So this was the rapid hardening cement. Next type of cement is Portland pozzolana cement. Now, as the name says, this is nothing but a cement which is produced by intergrinding OPC, ordinary Portland cement, with pozzolanic material. Now, what are pozzolanic materials? These are generally waste materials. For example, fly ash is a pozzolanic material, and silica fume is also a pozzolanic material. So there are various pozzolanic materials which are added into the OPC, and they are intergrinded together to get the Portland pozzolana cement. And What is particularly a pozzolana means? So pozzolana means a material, generally siliceous material, which is added into the OPC, ordinary Portland cement, but it does not have or possess cementitious properties. Means it will not have binding properties, and this material is nothing but siliceous materials. We have taken the examples fly ash, silica fume. You can also write volcanic ash, then calcined ash. So these are the examples of pozzolana materials which are siliceous in nature, but it will not possess any cementitious properties or binding properties. So this is the cement, Portland pozzolana cement. Now where this cement can be used? So this cement can be used at mass concreting, it can be also be used in hydraulic structures or marine construction. So these are the uses of pozzolana or Portland pozzolana cement. It can also be used in mass concreting, in hydraulic structures, in marine structures or marine constructions. This cement can be used, and this cement can also be used where OPC can be used. Ordinary Portland cement, we know that ordinary Portland cement is the most commonly used cement. So this cement can also be used where ordinary Portland cement can be used. So this was ordinary. So this was Portland pozzolana cement. The next type of cement is blast furnace slag cement. Now what is blast furnace slag? It is a waste material which is obtained in manufacturing of pig iron. It is nothing but a waste material, and at the time of manufacturing of this pig iron, it is generally obtained. So as it is a waste material and we are making cement out of it, therefore it is cheaper. And how this cement is manufactured? This first blast furnace slag is taken, it is added with ordinary Portland cement clinkers and also the gypsum, and we get this cement, that is blast furnace slag cement. First we take blast furnace slag from the pig iron manufacturing, then we also add cement clinkers, that is ordinary Portland cement clinkers, we also add gypsum in it, and the final product that we get is the blast furnace slag cement. Generally this cement has same properties as that of OPC, that is ordinary Portland cement, and this cement has same property. Only the early strength is less in case of this blast furnace slag cement, and rest of the properties of this cement are same, and its specific gravity is 3.04 and its specific surface area is greater than 4050 centimeter square per gram. This cement can also be used in the slain places where we can use sulfate resisting cement. Cement is used in mass concreting. As I told you before, that mass concreting may be, for example, dam, in the construction of dam. We can also use where there are chances of sulfate attacks. For example, due to soil. Certain soils will have sulfates in it. For example, if you are constructing any underground structure, therefore there are chances of soil which may come in contact with sulfates. There are chances of soils with sulfates which may come in contact with the structure or the cement, and therefore there are chances of sulfate attacks. So this cement can also be very good resistance, which shows very good resistance in providing the sulfate attacks. So this cement is very good in resisting sulfate attacks also. And in case of soil, cement can also be used in seawater constructions, where the construction has to be carried out under the sea, and also in the marine constructions, you can say marine constructions. This, and the cement can also be used in the construction of water retaining structures. Then in case of board piles construction, in board pile construction also, as it is an underground structure, there are chances of sulfate attack due to soil. So we can use this type of cement here also. And at last, we can also use it for carrying sewage or certain chemicals. So these are the uses of blast furnace slag cement. The next type of cement is low heat Portland cement. As the name says, it will have low rate of heat of hydration, means the liberation of heat will be at lower. Next, now how this cement is made low heat cement, or how this rate of heat of hydration can be controlled? So this low rate of hydration is achieved by low percentage of C3A and high percentage of C2S, that is tricalcium silicate, that is tricalcium aluminate, is kept at 5%. Dicalcium silicate is kept at percentage about 46%. So because of this low percentage of C3A and high percentage of C2S, we can say special property this cement has, that it has greater resistance to sulfate attacks. Now we will see the uses of this cement. The cement can be used in large raft slabs or raft foundations. It can also be used in construction of chemical factories. The cement is also used in mass concreting, where the cement required is in large quantity, for example dams, nuclear power plants. And this cement can also be used in bridge abutments, because as we know that bridge abutments are susceptible to sulfate attacks due to its underground construction. As we know that these bridge abutments are under the ground level, therefore in bridge construction we can use for the abutments the low heat Portland cement. As I said you that this cement will generate heat at a lower rate, therefore the strength development or initial strength development will also be at lower rate. Therefore it requires curing for long periods. So this is all about low heat Portland cement. We have seen that low heat Portland cement will have low heat of hydration, low rate of heat of hydration, and it can be achieved by low percentage of C3A, that is about 5%, and high percentage of C2S, that is dicalcium silicate, about 46%. And it has special property that It has greater resistance to sulfate attacks, and the uses are, it can be used in large raft slabs, then chemical factories, in mass concreting structures, and it can also be used in construction of bridge abutments. And the rate of development of strength is at a very lower rate. Therefore, curing for long period is required in this type of cement. Next type of cement is white cement. And again, as the name says, it is purely white in color. And it is manufactured by using China clay along with chalk, lime, and this chalk and lime should be free from all the impurities. Now, how to achieve this white color? We can reduce the percentage of iron oxide and manganese oxide, because what happens, due to the addition of iron oxide and manganese oxide in the cement, it gives greenish gray color to the cement. Therefore, we have to reduce the percentage of iron oxide as well as manganese oxide. Now we will see the uses of this type of cement. This type of cement is used first decorative works, then it can be also used in cladding work, that is wall cladding works, then it can also be used for flooring works of high class, and it is also used for ornamental work. So these are the uses of white cement. One more thing is that at the time of manufacturing, care should be taken. And what care should be taken? That in kiln, that is in blast furnace, when the ingredients of cement are burned, it should be burned either with oil or you can use gas. But use of coal should be avoided completely, because we need white cement, and if we are using coal as a material or as a fuel in the kiln, there are chances that the color may get changed. Therefore, the coal use should be strictly avoided at the time of burning the ingredients in the kiln. So this is white cement. In the continuation of this topic, the next type of cement is oil well cement. Now again, we have to identify from name itself, it will be used in oil well. When oil well exploration is carried out, this cement is used in the form of slurries. And the slurry is inserted at the time of exploration of oil wells. Generally, at the time of drilling of oil wells, this cement is used and it will be acted. We use this cement for cementing works of drilling of oil wells. At the time of drilling of oil wells, we use it as cementing works, and where it will be subjected to high pressures and high temperatures. As we know that we have to construct, or we have to drill, or we have to explore an oil well. At the time of exploring these oil wells, what we will do, we will take the oil well cement in the form of slurries, and this slurry is inserted by using drillings, and where it will be subjected to some high pressures and high temperatures. So this cement is capable of resisting high pressures and high temperatures also. Now, what are the components of this cement? The components of this cement will have either pozzolanic or Portland cement, and along with this we will also use retarders. And what is retarder? It is a type of admixture which is added into the concrete so as to modify the properties of concrete. And what is the function of retarder? It will slow down the process of hydration. Therefore, we will use retarders along with the pozzolanic or Portland cement, and that cement will be called as oil well cement. And this retarder will also prevent the cement from setting very quickly or early. So this is the function of retarders adding into this type of cement. And the main function of using this type of cement in oil well is that it will protect the well from corrosion as well as it will act as hydraulic seal, means it will not allow fluids to pass through it, and will act as a hydraulic seal for the well. So this is it for oil well cement. The next type of cement is sulfate resisting cement. So as the name says, it has high resistance to sulfate attacks. And to make this cement sulfate resisting, the amount of C3A, that is tricalcium aluminate, is restricted to 5% only, and it has high percentage of C2S, that is dicalcium silicate. Now let's see the uses of this cement. This cement can be used in underground structures. As we know that in underground structures, there are chances of sulfate attacks also. So we can use this type of cement in underground structures. Then we can also use this type of cement in basements. Then we can also use this type of cement in sewage treatment plants, in case of marine constructions, the structures which are constructed in marines. And at last, we can also use this type of cement in the construction of structures in coastal areas. Near the coastal areas, as we know that there are chances of sulfate attacks, therefore we can also use this type of cement in construction of areas where there are chances of coastal attacks, that is attacks of sulfate. And as I told you that this cement will have low percentage of or low content of C2S, so because of that, at early stages it will have low rate of strength development, but the ultimate strength will be high, because as we are reducing the percentage of C2S to some lower extent, what will happen at early stages, at initial stages, the strength development will be at lower rate, but ultimate strength will be same or it will be high. The next type of cement is hydrophobic cement. Now it has some special concept. For example, let us consider a cement particle here. Now this cement particles, if they are stored for a long period, what happens? There are chances that it will attract the water around its surface. So what we will do, we will produce a cement with general Portland cement and we will add some film forming substances. And the substances such as oleic acids or stearic acids. And what are these oleic acids and stearic acids? They are nothing but they are film forming substances. For example, this is a particle of cement. So by the addition of this oleic acid or stearic acid, it will form a film around the surface or around the particle. And because of that, we can store this cement for long period without any deterioration. So what is the main function of using these acids? It makes the cement hydrophobic, means it will repel the water from the particles of cement. So that is the concept behind hydrophobic cement. So we can define this cement by, it is a cement which is produced by grinding Portland cement clinkers with this Portland cement clinkers. What we added with them? The film forming substances. And the substances such as oleic acid or it may be stearic acid. And why they are added? To control or to reduce the deterioration of cement. And what is the advantage of this cement? This cement can be stored for long period without any deterioration, or it can even stored in damp climates where there are chances of dampness. So this film helps in transportation of cement over long distances, because there are chances of deterioration of this cement. So we can transport this cement for over a long distances also without any deterioration, as the film will be formed around the particle of the cement. Then we can also store this cement for long period storage of cement for long period without any deterioration, and we can also use in some unfavorable conditions. Unfavorable conditions may be humid climate or dampness. So even in this humid climates or dampness, we can store this cement for a long period without any deterioration or without any reduction in strength. So this was hydrophobic cement, and that is the last type of cement in types of cements. Thank you.